Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known. From you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Jesus said, "The first commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." Dearly beloved, let us come into the presence of the Almighty God, praying together as we kneel. All together. Most merciful God, I confess that I have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what I have done and by what I have left undone. I have not loved you with my whole heart. I have not loved my neighbor as myself. I am truly sorry and I humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on me and forgive me, that I may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
The Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Amen. Please stand.
The Gloria in excelsis together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to His people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Keep, O Lord, your household, the church, in your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion. For the sake of our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. A proclamation of the Word of God from the book of Numbers, chapter 12, beginning at verse 1. Then Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses because of the Cushite woman whom he had married, for he had married a Cushite woman. And they said, "Has the Lord indeed spoken only through Moses? Has he not spoken through us as well?" And the Lord heard it. Now the man Moses was very humble, more than any man who was on the face of the earth. Suddenly The Lord said to Moses and Aaron and to Miriam, "You three come out of the tent of meeting." So the three of them came out. Then the Lord came down in a pillar of cloud and stood at the doorway of the tent. And he called Aaron and Miriam. When they had both come forward, he said, "Hear now my words. If there is a prophet among you, I, the Lord, shall make myself known to him in a vision. I shall speak with him in a dream. Not so with my servant Moses. He is faithful in all my household. With him, I speak mouth to mouth, even openly, and not in dark sayings. And he beholds the form of the Lord. Why then were you not afraid to speak against my servant, against Moses?" So the anger of the Lord burned against them, and he departed. But when the cloud had withdrawn from over the tent, behold, Miriam was leprous, as white as snow. As Aaron turned toward Miriam, behold, she was leprous. Then Aaron said to Moses, "Oh, my Lord, I beg you, do not account this sin to us, in which we have acted foolishly and in which we have sinned. Oh, do not let her be like one dead, whose flesh is half eaten away when he comes from his mother's womb." Moses cried out to the Lord, saying, "O God, heal her, I pray." But the Lord said to Moses, "If her father has but spit in her face, would she not bear her shame for 7 days? Let her be shut up for 7 days outside the camp, and afterward she may be received again." So Miriam was shut up outside the camp for 7 days, and the people did not move on until Miriam was received again. Afterward, however, the people moved on from Hazareth and camped in the wilderness of Paran. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the responsorial psalm, which today is Psalm 83. O God, do not remain quiet, do not be silent, and O God, do not be still.
For behold, your enemies make an uproar, and those who hate you have exalted themselves.
They make shrewd plan against your people, and conspire together against your treasured ones.
They have said, "Come and let us wipe them out as a nation, that the name of Israel be remembered no more."
For they have conspired together with one mind. Against you they make a covenant.
The tents of Edom and the Ishmaelites, Moab and the Hagrites,
Gebal and Ammon and Amalek, Philistia with the inhabitants of Tyre.
Assyria also has joined with them. They have become a help to the children of Lot.
Deal with them as with Midian, as with Sisera and Jabin at the torrent of Kishon.
Who were destroyed at Endor, who became us dung for the ground.
Make their nobles like Oreb and Zeb, and their princes like Ziba and Zalmunna.
Who said, let us possess for ourselves the pastures of God.
Oh my God, make them like the whirling dust, like chaff before the wind.
Like fire that burns the forest, and like a flame that sets the mountains on fire.
So pursue them with your tempests, and terrify them with your storm.
Fill their faces with dishonor. That they may seek your name, O Lord,
Let them be ashamed and dismayed forever, and let them be humiliated and perish.
That they may know that you alone, whose name is the Lord, are the Most High over all the earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Please be seated. A proclamation of the Word of God from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 2, beginning at verse 12. For all who have sinned without the law will also perish without the law, and all who have sinned under the law will be judged by the law. For it is not the hearers of the law who are just before God, but the doers of the law will be justified. For when Gentiles who do not have the law do instinctively the thing of the law, these, not having the law, are a law to themselves, in that they show the work of the law written in their hearts, their conscience bearing witness, and their thoughts alternately accusing or else defending them. On the day when, according to the gospel, God will judge the secrets of man through Christ Jesus. But if you bear the name Jew and rely upon the law and boast in God and know his will and approve the things that are essential, being instructed out of the law, and are confident that you yourself are a guide to the blind, a light to those who are in darkness, a corrector of the foolish, a teacher of the immature, having in the law the embodiment of knowledge and of truth. You, therefore, who teach another, do you not teach yourself? You who preach that one shall not steal, do you steal? You who say that one should not commit adultery, do you commit adultery? You who uphold idols, do you rob temples? You who boast in the law through your breaking the law, do you dishonor God? For the name of God is blasphemed among the Gentiles because of you, just as it is written. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord be on our minds, our lips, and our hearts as we hear his holy gospel. The holy gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew chapter 18.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Today we are reading from the gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 18 from verses 10 through 20. And Jesus said, "See that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I say to you that their angels in heaven continually behold the face of my Father who is in heaven. For the Son of Man has come to save that which was lost. What do you think? If any man has 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray, does he not leave the 99 on the mountains and go and search for the one that is straying? And if it turns out that he finds it, truly I say to you, he rejoices over it more than over the 99 which have not gone astray. Thus, it is not the will of your Father who is in heaven that one of these little ones perish. And if your brother sins, Go and reprove him in private. If he listens to you, you have won your brother. But if he does not listen to you, take one or two with you, so that by the mouth of two or three witnesses, every fact may be confirmed. And if he refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if he refuses to listen even to the church, let him be to you as a Gentile and a tax gatherer. Truly I say to you, whatever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again I say to you, that if two of you agree on earth about anything that they may ask, it shall be done for them by my Father who is in heaven. For where two or three have gathered together in my name, there I am in their midst.
Amen.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. And that is why on this morning, we always greet each other, good morning, because God is good. And as we begin this day, we are blessed by God to be entrusted with another day of our lives. And not only blessed with and being entrusted, but blessed by being empowered, that as we now join each other, we can see how God will work mightily in our lives. Our Lord Jesus Christ, when He came, demonstrated the ability, the character, and the authority of God in the flesh as He walked through this earth. He did that so that after He ascends to heaven, a great company of men and women, you and I, will be able to demonstrate an even greater way the very ability, character, and authority of God. In other words, Jesus came to show us that we now are empowered to do what He has done. In John chapter 14, verse 12, a very familiar scripture, He said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, the works that I do, you shall do, and even greater works than these that I do, because I go to the Father." There is a great potential in the people of God whom He has called. And as we journey in these weeks of ordinary time, a time ordained by God in order that we can indeed walk and live in the kingdom of God. And there are principles, there are ways and methods that God has shown in His Word in order that we can live in the kingdom, even here on earth. It is sad because Christianity today is oblivious, is unaware, is ignorant of the things about the kingdom of God. We see religion only as a way and a means whereby we can be able to just get what we want, rather than understand what does God really want. And so as we look at the readings today, we see how God continues to protect that kingdom in the church, and how He begins to correct ways that we may have which are not according to the ways that He set in His kingdom. That's why in the first reading we saw how Moses, Aaron, and Miriam were corrected by God particularly Aaron and Miriam, in order that the people can continue to journey. Do you notice after the correction, after all that has taken place, it is then and only then, which says in the last verse, Miriam was shut up outside the camp for 7 days, and the people did not move until Miriam was received again. Afterward, the people move out from Hazeroth and camped in the wilderness of Paran. Sa kasalanan ng isang tao, naapektuhan yung pagsulong ng karamihan. All we need to realize is that the ways of God are ways that are not individualistic, hindi pang sarili lamang. Hindi buhay mo lamang ang kinakailangan mong alalahanin. Tandaan natin, sabi sa Romans chapter 14, walang sino man ang nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang. Walang sino man ang namamatay para sa sarili lamang. Tayong lahat ay may pananagutan sa isa't isa. That's why in Romans, again, Paul was talking to the Romans and mentioning to them the importance of God's presence in their lives. Last Sunday, we saw the power, the potential of the seed. Ang bisa, ang kapangyarihan ng isang butil ng binhi. Today, I would like to show to us from the Word the power and the potential of the gathering. Ang bisa, ang kapangyarihan ng pagtitipon. Yun po ang pamagat ng isa sa mga gawain natin dito, pagtitipon. Lalingid sa ating kalaman na yung pagtitipon na yun ay hitik na hitik sa kapangyarihan at bisa upang makita natin ang lalaman ng sinasabi ni Jesus, greater works than these shall you do. As we look at the gospel today, we see how Jesus places us in the context of the gathering, the context of the assembly. From the very beginning, God did not design one person, a few individuals. He designed a community. And He called it the church. And the church has been empowered, kaya nga ang simula po ng ordinary time ay nagtatapos ang Easter ng Pentecost na nagiging hudyat din ng simula natin upang paglalakbay natin sa susunod na mga 20, mahigit sa 20 linggo ng paglalakbay sa ordinary time. May Holy Spirit tayong kasama. Sabi nga dun sa huling verses ng Bible sa Revelation 22, the Spirit and the Bride. It is always the Spirit and the Bride. And the Bride is the people of God, the assembly that gathers together. And this begins every Sunday wherein we gather. And I would just like to zero in on that because many times, especially during the 3 years of the pandemic, many people have still acquired the feeling that church is an option. Many people have thought that church is something that I can decide on my own. Pero nakikita natin na dahil doon sa ganung uring pag-iisip, unti-unting nanghihina tayo sa ating buhay. Because there is power, there is potential in the gathering. We have to realize that we draw power from itself, from ourselves. Kaya nga sa Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, he sabi doon, forsaking not our own assembling together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging, empowering, exhorting one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. Huwag daw nating iwaksi ang pagtitipon. Huwag nating baliwalain. Many times we come to church and then after that, we forget all about that. Hindi natin alam doon taglay sa pamamagitan ng assembly. Kaya nga sa Panginoon palaging tinatawag ang Israel doon sa tent of the meeting, doon sa pagtitipon. He begins to deal with us according to our gathering, the assembling. Kung mapapansin natin dito sa mga readings, lalong-lalo na yung mga sulat ni Paul, hindi po sulat to doon sa isang tao lamang. Karamihan ang sulat niya. Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians, lahat pong yan ay nakatuon sa karamihan at sa lipon ng mga taong nagtitipon para sa kanya. And so I want to just encourage us, do not forsake the assembling together. Whenever you have the ability and the chance, come to church. Yes, I recognize there is ability even in the social media. But I believe that is just a means to help those that could not come. We should make the effort as much as we can to be here to assemble. Because God meets us where He has called us to gather. He meets us in that place where He wants us to be so that we can become His people, that we can now be sent out to the world. Pansinin po natin yung ating collect for this whole week. Sabi po doon sa collect na yon na binasa at pinagdinadasal natin araw-araw itong linggong to, simula nung linggo, sabi noon, "Keep, O Lord, your household," yung sambahay mo, "the church, in your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion." I'm excited every time I pass through the stairs. Sana napapansin natin yung mensahe na nakikita natin sa mga larawan kung papaano ang simbahan ang kumikilos, yung iba't ibang ministries. Dahil ang dami ng ministry sa simbahan ay bunga ng isang Panginoon at isang Diyos na kumikilos sa lahat ng yun. At kung hindi ka pa member ng ministry, sumali ka. Dahil hindi tayo pwedeng nakatingin lamang. Hindi tayo pwedeng spectators lamang. Kinakailangan tayo ay maging participants, that we need to abide with Him as He abides with us. Manatili sa Kanya gaya ng pananatili niya sa atin. Mga minamahal, mga kapatid, may kapangyarihan ang pagtitipon. May kapangyarihan ang sinisimulan bawat linggo. At wag na wag nating kalilimutan at pababayan, iwawaksi ang tungkuling ito. Ano man ang mangyari, we have to make church gatherings our priority. Dahil ito po ang paraan ng Panginoon upang mabiyayaan ang mundong nangangailangan ng kanyang buhay. Tayo po ang daluyan. Tayo po ang vessels of honor fit for His use. At nangyayari po yan kapag tayo ay nagtitipon-tipon. "Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brothers and sisters to dwell together in unity. It is like the oil that flows upon the head, upon flowing down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard." Yung langis daw po na nagtatalaga at naghihilang doon sa saserdote upang magkaroon siya ng empowerment ay binubuhos sa ulo, sa ating obispo, sa ating patriarch, sa ating mga kaparian, upang dumaloy sa pagtitipon. Alam niyo po, yung langis na yon ay hindi po isang kakapiranggot na kutsarita. Kung babasahin po natin, that oil that is poured upon Aaron is 6 liters, 1.5 gallons. Kaya nga, talagang dumadaloy at umaabot hanggang sa pinakakaduluduluhan ng kanyang suot. Because the anointing of God is the fullness of which we have received, of His fullness. John 1:16, we have received, and grace upon grace. bawat isa sa atin, wala pong hinananampalataya na ipinetsipwere ng Panginoon. Tayong lahat ay nagkaroon ng bisa at kapangyarihan upang magampanan yung greater works na yon na sinabi ng Panginoon sa atin. Ako po excited dahil sa mga susunod na linggo, tayo po ay nabiyaya ng pagpresensya ng Patriarch last Sunday. Hindi po yon isang nagkataon lamang. Yung po ay isang hudyat. Yung po ay isang signal sa simbahan upang rise up, O Church. Let God arise and let His enemies be scattered. Upang ang mga bagay-bagay sa buhay natin ay magkaroon ng kaganapan ayon sa gusto ng Panginoon sa atin. Let us rise up, people of God. Let us, as Paul said, reaching forward and move upward as we look into the very fullness of Christ in our lives. The power, the potential of the gathering and the assembling of God's people. Amen.
Please stand. Let us respond as a body as we confess the Apostles' Creed together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, and the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church and for the world. Almighty Father, we lift before you your Holy Catholic Church.
That you would lead us in truth, baptize us in love, and unite us in spirit.
We pray for her leaders, especially Bishop Craig and Bishop Ariel.
That they may, with one voice, minister your life to your people and the world.
We lift before you the people of this community, this nation, and the world.
That we may honor one another and serve the common good.
We pray for our governmental leaders, especially President Marcos.
That you would lead them in the ways of justice and peace.
We lift before you all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit.
That you would send your comfort and grace upon them.
Father, we specifically lift up to you these, our brothers and sisters in Christ. Father, as we profess their name, may your healing grace truly be manifested in their lives, that they may find comfort and healing, Lord, by the wounds that you bear. So we pray for Gloria, Tess, Charmaine, Grace, Rose, Mitch, Kenneth, Merlin, Fe, Maria Loreto, Fur, Dennis, Antonio, Virgilie, Marisa, Vic, Carrie, Marinelle, Christine Ann and Lucas, Preshell, Nelia, Edith, Perry, Light, Desigem, Preselin, Recto, Shanros, Thomas, Simeon, Grace, Nelson, Juminard, Ferdinovem, Jinky, and Teresa. Father, in your mercy, hear our prayer in their behalf.
Yes, Lord.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Grant we may share with them in your everlasting kingdom.
Together, let us lift up our corporate petition. Almighty God and King, our dwelling place in all generations, owner of the earth and all it contains, Grant unto us our allotted inheritance, we pray, and the grace to build upon it facilities in which your people, being restored in your image and ever growing in love for you, might become a habitation of your presence and ministers of your life, to the glory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns together with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Grant, mighty Lord, that we, your people, live out your productivity and flourish in your life as we live according to your kingdom. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Beloved of the Lord, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer one another the sign of God's peace. Peace, Señor. The power of the gathering expressed as we come now to offer our lives to Him, preparing to receive the very power from heaven, the bread from heaven, today as we now come, bring our offerings to the Lord. Let us continue to express our gratefulness to God as we lead all of creation in the doxology. Together, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we receive this bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become the body of Christ.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in our Lord's divinity, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we receive this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become the blood of Christ.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we bring these tithes and offerings before you. They will be used in your church for the work you've set before us and for the furthering of your kingdom. Lord, by your mercies, wash away my iniquities. Cleanse me from all my sin. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. And amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give thanks to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate his death. With living faith, we proclaim his resurrection. And with unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. Now, with the saints and all the angels, we praise you forever. Holy,
holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy.
Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine.
Please kneel.
We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
Lord have mercy.
After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is the blood of my new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." My Lord and my God, have mercy on us.
Please stand.
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Remember your servants, Craig, our patriarch, Ariel, our bishop, all the clergy, and all your faithful people. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah!
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Jesus died for you, and feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. The body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring life eternal to us who believe.
Fears, fears, fears.
May we have a revelation into the amazing grace of God that He has provided to His people. It is an amazing grace that will do amazing things in and through your life. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of His body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you always.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.